everybody. It's Cinnamon Cooney, your Art Sherpa, and today we are finally kicking off Abstract Week. Today we're painting this fun pop art abstracted pug in multiple colors. It's so much fun. Do you guys like this? So I'm super excited about doing it. It's going to be like really, really entertaining. If you check the description, that's those words down below, and you click the little more button, it's going to pop open a bunch more information. In there is a link to the traceable and the finished painting. I think both of those things will help you. And if you check the iCard, little pop out info card menu, it's going to give you a playlist to the Big Art Quest. If you've been doing the Big Art Quest, you're so ready for this painting because you know how to mix all the colors. It's not even a thing anymore. And you know how to transfer the image on the canvas. You're like, yeah, I'm ready. I got this. And if you're not, check out the Big Art Quest. It'll help you get ready for these fun art adventures. And I'm ready for an art adventure today, John.
Oh, yeah?
This is John, my sweet husband. He follows me with the camera. He's a Sherpa tracker.
I am. I'm a Sherpa tracker.
Sherpa tracker. Because who knows where the Sherpa's going to go?
Hiding on the screen somewhere.
John knows. So enjoy that part of the show, because as John tries to follow me around from the palette cam to this camera to our up-close cam, I always manage to throw him off. And that, I think that's entertaining. Mm-hmm. Who do we have in the audience today?
Oh my gosh, there's so many people. Of course, we have all of our wonderful moderators out here. You know, excuse me.
Hey, everybody.
Ken Sim, Mona. We have Flame Gremlins there. I think I saw Bonnie there earlier. And Flame Gremlin was saying I need to give a shout out to Tina.
Hi, Tina.
So, hi, Tina.
Thanks
for joining us. And you know, there's a whole slew of other people out here with us today. And I've just seen Janie Gordon.
Hi.
Valerie,
there's everybody's here, and so good to see you. If you're watching in the replay, before you click away, what this is when we do these live, and then we leave them up for replay. So yeah. We're not just having an imaginary friend moment.
Wetzel's birthday.
Wetzel's birthday!
Yep.
Happy birthday, Wetzel. Happy birthday, Wetzel. Happy birthday, Wetzel. Happy birthday to you.
Yep.
Yeah, that just happened. Like you went to one of those restaurants that sing to you. But the Sherpa did. So we're going to start out. I want to put like 2 or 3 wishes on the canvas today. I like to put words, intentions, quotes, or wishes on my canvas. It's just a thing you can do as an artist. You don't have to do it. You can just fast forward right through wishes if you don't feel like doing it. But I really encourage it.
Yeah, wishes are really good. You should stay for it.
You should stay for it. You're right. You should stay for it. John's right. He's like, why are you encouraging people to go?
Yeah, no,
stay. Because it's wonderful and it's heartwarming and it makes you feel better. Do you have a wish for me today?
Yeah, for Honor's birthday and Wetzel's birthday.
For Honor's birthday and Wetzel's birthday.
Yeah, that's
awesome. So let's do a happy birthday. This canvas forever. We'll have this when they x-ray it later. They'll be like, what? All right. And 2 hearts because we mean it.
Now, we have a wish for Allison for her her son Greg's healing and treatment.
Okay.
We're going to send some wishes out there for all the people who are looking for work.
Yes, I have a wish I want to add to that in my heart to make employment reigns. I'm going to put this here. Employment for all our viewers that are looking for work. We wish that.
We have some wishes for Carrie, especially for some safe travel. She's going to be doing a lot of traveling this weekend by car and would like some love and the safe wishes for that.
All right. And I want to add a last and final wish.
Oh, yeah.
Which is that dogs everywhere. Pets and dogs everywhere are treated like the valuable, important companions that they are, and that they go to sleep tonight just a little bit safer. If we missed a wish that you saw in... What, John?
Oh, yeah. There's a bunch of wishes up
there. Yeah. If we ever miss a wish, you know, what I would encourage you to do, if you see one that speaks to you, you know, you can add somebody else's wish into your canvas. And you can make sure that you put your own wish in. I just want to caution you that I'm using a watercolor pencil by Artist Loft. These are very inexpensive. That's how I sketch in my drawings. And they disappear into the paint. But if I were to use, say, like a neon color, it might even show through. So, you know, just a little thing to think about. Don't get a Sharpie out and write your wishes in, or they're going to bleed through.
Well, I did want to send one more congratulations. This is just a congratulations, though.
Okay, so, I would love to hear congratulations.
So Penny, on her daughter's 50th birthday, she managed to get her daughter through 50 years. So congratulations, Penny.
Dude, yeah. I got one in 11, and I'm like, I don't even know how. So congratulations. Oh, such a morning with Honey John.
Oh, it happened.
Yeah. Oh, no, it was. No, not that kind of a morning. We were riding in the car. I have to share this with you. I know this is chatty, and you're like, what? Stay. You need to hear this. This blew my mind. And we were talking about what a big deal Google and YouTube is, that it was the big invention of her generation. And I said, that's as important as, say, the combustion engine or as, you know, impactful as the nuclear bomb. And she said, what's a nuclear bomb?
Wow.
That just got me. And I was trying to explain to her about getting under the desk for nuclear drills and the day after tomorrow and growing up, you know, afraid of that. And she's like, well, we've never used one, have we?
That's
it was
awesome.
Just a crazy conversation. They don't talk about it at all in school. How the world has changed, John.
Wow.
How the world has changed. Paint.
Paint.
Since I'm feeling so optimistic, kids don't even know what a nuclear atom bomb is, I now feel like painting. It actually really made my morning.
Yep.
This wonderful group of paint. This is acrylic heavy-bodied paint. I'm painting Liquitex today. It looks like it's all, oh, and one golden. I'm painting Liquitex in golden, but you can get any heavy-bodied paint. I am using the colors Cadmium Yellow Medium, Cad Red Medium, Dioxazine Purple, Burnt Sienna, Yellow Ochre, sometimes called Yellow Oxide, Titanium White, Mars Black, and Phthalo Blue.
Yep.
In the description, you'll see those colors. A tip, you can save money by purchasing hue on the cadmium colors and possibly increase safety.
Yep.
But I'm a rebel. I just paint cadmium.
Could you push that little cam? There.
Woohoo! Perfect. I almost had a tube of paint fall in there, but yes, I can.
That's awesome.
So I'm going to sketch him in just real fast. Of course, you have the traceable. Of course, you have all that. But just in case you want to follow along, John, you'll have to tell me if the up-close cam is...
We're on it.
We're on it. So I'm going to draw this quite dark. Please don't sketch this in as dark on your canvas. I'm doing it so you can see it. So the first thing I'm going to sketch in is this sort of little M shape at the top of the canvas. This is about 3 fingers from the top of my 16 by 20 canvas. Then I'm going to come down and do a curve inward followed by an outward curve. You see that?
Make his chubby head.
He's got a chubby head because pugs should all have chubby heads. This pug reminds me of our pug Ishtar. She crossed the Rainbow Bridge a couple years ago, but she was a lovely dog.
Yes.
Coming around here. So we've just curved this in and then curved it out. Now I'm going to make a little line down the middle, and that's going to anchor everything that's happening. And right where this curve is, I'm going to make a little hill. That's actually how I sketch him in. I make this little hill. Isn't that a nice little hill?
Yeah.
That's his little muzzle, because they have little muzzly punched in little faces of cuteness. It's probably really not good for the dog, but it's so adorable! I'm really kind of into pugs. I'm going to make a little curve here underneath. Or you could think of this as like a little frown.
Mm-hmm.
Then there's an inward scoop like a Batman wing and another inward scoop like a Batman wing. Do the Batman wing on the other side. And what do you know? You have a dog's nose. Then all I've got to do is on each side do some parentheses or an 11.
Uh-huh.
And do these little curves. And I have dog nostrils. Isn't that crazy? So easy. I'm going to come down about 3 fingers and make a little mark.
Mm-hmm.
Make a little line there. So then I know I want to make a little scoopy pug smile like that. And a little scoopy pug smile like that.
Scoopy pug smile. I like that.
Scoopy, it's technical art terms. And I really want you to hang in with me on these technical art terms.
We have a vocabulary.
Now, when I did this, I was just like really into the whole little tug thing coming out. My dog used to do this. She couldn't even run away from home. You remember that? She would like run away and get to the next trash cans and then be like, fall down and be like.
She'd get winded in the next yard.
People would be like, your dog's passed out in my yard. She's so funny.
You have to adjust your close-up down just a touch.
Okay. It really cracks me up. Go rescue the dog. We couldn't take her for walkies. We had to put her in the stroller with the baby. She right underneath. All right. So I'm going to scoop this down. I'm going to make a little tongue out. This is sort of like a little slide that I'm making here. And then I'm going to come around and come up. And where I'm going to make this look like a tongue is about right here on this curve. I'm going to bring a little line and join it. And that's how I'm going to have the up. So you know how that fat, weird tongue that rolls over? That's how I did that. You could just do it with like a little tongue. This is your abstract pug. This is abstracted art, John. This isn't true abstract. This is abstracted art.
Ah.
So in other words, I've taken representational art, but I've just abstracted it a little bit. I've made it a little non-representational. Hmm. A true abstract would not look like a pug. I would just put a lot of paint up here and call it pug. This is the truth.
What?
That's what would happen. I would still have to use design and all kinds of art skills, but that's basically what I do. Is I do freeform paint and call it pug. And then everyone was like, that's a very good abstract. All right. We're doing abstracts Saturday.
You're close up.
Yeah, thank you.
So I'm going to scroll back up here because there's a funny
I'm not at all disrespectful to abstract art. Just things are what they are. You know, I mean, it's like low jeans are low jeans. And abstract art is you paint a bunch of freeform paint. You use your skills and your techniques and your design, but you're not painting, you know, a representational picture. And then you call it something. Or well, sometimes you'd like to number 153 because you're so intellectual. Okay. I'm gonna make a little ear here. So how I do the ear is I do a little bump and another little bump and I join it down. It kind of makes their little triangle ears. They have the little foldy over ears.
Oh yeah,
I love the foldy over ears. I'm gonna make a little bump and a little foldy over ear.
So Shelley had a pug.
Did she?
Named Brutus Bogart McKenzie. That's not a great name.
Brutus Bogart McKenzie.
That's a pug.
Yes, it is. I'm going to make his little chin down here.
Okay, you have to adjust. I mean, why don't you zoom out on the close-up camera?
Okay. Just zoom out. Well, that's the wrong direction.
There you go.
All right. Down. So there I've got that. You kind of see it sketching in. Again, we've got a traceable. So drawing is not your requirement for doing him.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to add a little wrinkle here above the nose and another little wrinkle above the nose. And that's where I'm going to start my eye line. See, I curve a little line up. Make a little circle underneath. Curve a little line up. Make a little circle underneath. That just lets me know where that is. And that's really all I need to have sketched in to paint him in. Because I paint him in all crazy.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to paint him in all crazy.
Crazy paint.
Just to remind you. It's not like, you know, an orderly plan here. And here's the deal.
What's the deal?
You know, if you need to follow along exactly, absolutely do that. Absolutely do that. But you can also just do it your way. This is definitely Sinatra moment in your life. So in abstract art, it is the absolute expression of your way. Yes, you have to follow the rules of design and composition and think about thirds and golden proportion and all those things.
Or break them if you know how.
Color theory, you know, lots of fun stuff, but it's not so regimented and required. All right. I am painting. I'm going to say who this is. This is my number 10 Simply Simlins. We call her Goldilocks. I stole her. My mom says I stole her. I say she was abandoned here after the nutcracker. Am I okay? You're getting up. Okay. Well, we're going to do that after, right? Should I show them? Okay, so here's what's come in the mail. Thanks to you guys. Actually, I think really thanks to Susan, but it may have been a bunch of people. They sent me brushes. But here's the important thing, right? Brushes in a box aside, which is very exciting. And we're going to show this off probably Sunday. This is a number 10 Simply Simmons Bright Extra Firm Filament.
Mm-hmm.
Get the extra firms in this line because that's what this. Remember, I was like, what brush is this? You guys found it for me.
Yeah.
And now I have more. So this is my number 10 Bright Extra Firm Filament. Love it. Love it. And I'm going to make some green with my phthalo and my CAD sort of fun stuff. So I'm going to come over here. And I'm going to get a little yellow. I'm not going to mix it. I'm just moistening my brush because it was a little dry. I don't know if you guys can see that there.
Yeah.
That's the bead. You see the bead? There's the bead.
The green bead.
Yeah. I'm just letting you know how I load my brush. See, because I really keep it to this tip here. I don't get it up into the ferrule. And I'm going to just very loosely with this fabulous yummy brush that Goldilocks. I'm like actually taking care of Goldilocks. I'm going to get some just yellow this time. Load it on the. So see, it's mixing on the canvas. This is something you do in abstract art. You mix the paint on the canvas.
Mm.
super fun stuff. I'm not getting more water because this is, you know, got enough moisture on it to flow. You can use better flow agents than water, but water is free. Right. That's really what it is. Water is free. I just dipped in the water, grabbing some more yellow and some more blue. And I'm coming here. Coming around here. Around his face. We're going to come back in and make it even more abstracted. Right? Let's get some white. I think that would be really pretty right here. Just thinking about what's going on. And then I'm going to come over and do something kind of crazy. I'm going to get some brown. And some blue. Look at that.
Oh.
So I'm even sort of even going off page from my original thing because you do an abstract. You almost cannot help yourself. I'm going to try to be a good girl and get into my Dioxazine Purple. Just make sure I've got some down here because I did.
Adjust your close-up camera down a little bit.
Okay. So just see how completely free-spirited I am.
You may want to zoom that in a little bit too.
I might need to what?
Zoom it in a little bit.
Zoom it in.
That way.
So many instructions, John.
You know, that way
so many. I'm going to pick up a little more burnt sienna, and I've got this.
See, that way you can see how that.
See, that's going with the burnt sienna and the Dioxazine Purple, which if you've painted with me at all, you know I really like for backgrounds and different things. And I'm just being really, really loose with it. I do want to cover the canvas completely, and this brush is helping me do that. That's one of the reasons why I got excited about this brush when I got it before I knew how much it cost. And John can verify that's absolutely true.
Yeah.
Because my mom's always getting brushes from reps and stuff because, you know, Jerry's, she was teaching over there. And, I just figured it was just some like super brush or uber brush. And she said it was the reps brush. So I thought it was like a brush you only got if you met the rep. Because I couldn't find it. But now you, thanks to you guys, going firm filament, I found it. And now I can find its friends, everyone who lives in its family. So I'm going to keep continuing this darker color down here on. So see how this bright, warm color here and this dark color down here? I'm thinking about the design. I'm thinking that the darker color has weight.
Okay, so this color scheme that you're using, does it have a particular name to it?
No.
Okay.
No.
So, yeah.
I did not have a plan. I wasn't like, hey, let's use a tratic or harmonic or any particular color scheme. This is, I would say if we were to try to reference this down in anything, say this is akin to pop art.
No, you're not dry brushing, are you?
No. There is a small depth. I'm going to get some of this green off my brush and rub it on. Look at me. I'm just getting paint off going, off onto the canvas, you. Now I'm going to rinse out just a little bit to pull the purple out because I'm about to warm this color scheme up. And I'm going to start grabbing a little burnt and a little ochre and come right here. Look at that. We're going to talk about considered color schemes in future.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, what I'd say I'm playing with more is things like figure foreground. What color is warmer and pulls closer to the canvas? To what color stays back.
Yeah.
You know, and like everything else, layers. Ogres have layers. Paintings have layers. Do you have layers? I bet you do.
Maybe.
How's everybody doing today? Are we getting our paint on?
Yeah,
I'm so excited to paint today.
Yeah, it's pretty good. We got like 125 people out here painting with us today.
So excellent.
It's a pretty nice room full of folks. And it was funny, Bonnie was saying that she was watching one of our other videos and found Steve Ramsey with us and just loves his channel. So.
Oh, isn't he a hoot and a half?
He's a funny guy, huh?
And I think he does the best sponsored ads.
Yes,
like,
I think so.
I love this through here. So I grabbed some yellow ochre and some white and I blended it in through here.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to bring this over to that because John wasn't watching for you guys. You should yell at him.
You can zoom out a little bit.
Okay. That's the wrong direction, isn't
See, it? There you go. Okay.
All right. So we're going to finish out the rest of this. So I'm going to bring this out here. And I'm going to come and get into my green again. And my yellow ochre. And my blue. Bringing this around here. So we have this very colorful if we get into the cow you guys have been talking about. Now Saturday is the viewer directed abstract. It's true abstract. We're doing a true abstract. And you go to the Facebook page and vote for what you want. I'm going to take some of those suggestions and use it. Now, so you can show up and see if I took your suggestion. I grabbed some more yellow here.
Now, there's a question up here about the colors here. I'm not sure you get it from
another question
Alex.
About the colors.
It says, to get orange, do you add more yellow or red?
Okay. Well, anytime you mix red and yellow, you have orange. But then you have this whole range of oranges, right? You have oranges that are more to the red and more to the yellow. So if you want, say, a more fall orange, a more deep in the forest orange, you would have more red. But say you wanted something like a sunset over the ocean, you'd go more to the yellow. So that's like our color mixing quest, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Where we showed like if you were yellow dominant or red dominant.
Mm-hmm.
And what that color would look like. And that's why those charts are so good. So good to have. I grabbed yellow, blue, and a little bit of white. Now, and I'm coming around over the top of Mr. Puggles.
Now, what were we talking about your little brush
calling? What is Mr. Puggles' name today? I think we need to decide that as a community. Because I didn't have a name. John's like, what's this painting's name? I'm like, I don't know what this painting's name is. I don't know. Pugface.
Well, that's a good thing. We'll ask the community here to help us name
this
Mr. Puggles here something.
Because otherwise he'll just stay Mr. Puggles. That's right. How I am.
Well, Eve was asking something about brush strokes here.
Okay.
And she's saying, are the brush strokes supposed to be seen on the canvas?
Okay, sometimes yes, sometimes no. In this painting, I would say a resounding yes. You shouldn't see the white of the canvas shining through. We are trying to definitely cover this. And if your brush was, say, really soft and your canvas were, say, inexpensive like my canvas is here, you might have some trouble doing that. You can improve your situation by adding a little water to your brush.
Uh-huh.
Improving the flow. So if you look around here, let's see if I can really hold this up. I think you can really see these brush strokes. Where is it? Oh, there it is.
We got some good names. There's some good ones coming in.
What are you seeing?
I there's a couple, like Sir Pugs-a-Lot is good.
Sir Pugs-a-Lot.
Sorry.
I don't know why that's just so amusing to me, but it is.
Rory G. Puggles.
Rory G. Puggles. Mr. Rory G. Puggles. In the house today. We'll make up some more green. Blue dominant green.
Bogart.
Oh, that's good.
Puggle the dog. George, just George.
Yeah.
Sir Pugs-a-Lot is getting a lot of...
I like Sir Pugs-a-Lot.
Painterly Pug.
Painterly Pug.
Call him Skittles, the rainbow dog.
You know, he is. This is not a Skittles sponsors video, but it could have been.
It could have been.
If I had thought about it anymore, I could have sponsored this by Skittles. So I'm just painting his chin down here. Just his chin part with this green.
You're off the close-up, though. I'm off the reservation.
I'm off the reservation. Okay. Yeah. Okay. And I'm going to come get some purple. You're like, wait, what? I'm going to come get some purple.
Pugly.
And I'm going to come around here with this purple.
Mona's voting for Pugly.
Pugly. Come around his cheek with some purple.
TJ Pug.
I might even go off here. Just kind of crazy with these brush strokes. Let me go crazy. Abstract is in some ways harder than, especially once you start to abstract something. It doesn't actually get easier to not paint it realistically. But it does get fun.
Mm-hmm.
And that's kind of the important thing. So I'm going to get just a little blue. I'm going to come here with this blue, under the eye with this blue. What I'm doing, if you're not catching, is I'm making these little zones, these little spaces.
You have to pull your close-up camera to the right just a bit.
Okay, thank you. I love that John helps me.
Okay, cool.
We have a better show because of it. I really feel so.
Because I push all the buttons?
Well, besides pushing all the buttons, you let me know what we can see and what we can't see, and that is incredibly helpful. So I've come up along this line here, and I'm kind of brushing this in. I'm curving this in.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm doing. It's kind of a curved in stroke, and I might carry this blue under his eye. Under the eye. And I'm not having to be so particular about my brush stroke here, am I? Except where I'm trying to curve it. So I guess I do pay a little bit of attention because I kind of curve here and I kind of curve there. You know, where else am I going to do this blue? I think I'm going to come around this other side and do a similar thing here.
Ooh, Ghost Huntress thinks that the pug's name should be Filbert.
Filbert.
I think that's funny. There's been some good names that have come through here. Like, it was funny, I think it was Debbie? Yeah, Debbie said that she had a German Shepherd named D.O.G. And remember, my uncle Kevin had a dog named D.O.G.
I know. I love people that like D.O.G.
And there was a...
I feel like that's sort of clever.
I think Kim Sim said she had an in-law that named their dog. So, you know.
Well, does keep it easier, doesn't it?
It does.
Dog knows what you're talking about. He's like, I know that bark. That bark means me. That bark means treaty goodies yummies.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Yeah. I'm unfortunately a treaty mom.
As you can tell by our pugs are very round.
Yeah. I got that lecture from the... Huh?
I was like, where do you keep going? She's disappearing today.
It's abstract day. I don't even know where I'm going. Good luck to you, because I don't even know where I'm going. So I'm going to just bring this around here.
Mm.
You know.
Consuela says, a dog named cat and a horse named cow.
Horse won't put up with that. A horse will know, and a horse will get you. So I'm going to just take this over here, kind of like a little bit off, breaking up this line. But just so you see, I scrumble.
You scrumble?
I scrumbled it.
Now, did you add any slow dry medium to this?
No.
No?
No, you can. You can add retarding mediums or slow dry mediums.
Mm-hmm.
I have not yet been wowed. The reason I'm like, I've shown you guys this and I've let you know, and I guess they do maybe slow. It's hard to tell on these lights, too. It's like hard for me to even test it. I haven't been like blown away or impressed yet by it.
Hmm.
I haven't run into a product where I'm like, this product changes everything. I've kind of found products where I'm like, this product kind of does what it says on the jar. I'm coming underneath the ear and adding this weird little shadow. And then I'm also going to come down the middle of this ear and add this dark color right here. Kind of like a little dart.
Cool.
Leaving the white around it. Ooh. And then I got paint on my finger because that's what you do.
Oh, good to go.
I'm coming over here. Can you see me over here on the
up
close?
I can see you. Okay. Everybody's saying they love your ring too.
Oh, thank you. My friend Claire gave me this ring. My good friend Claire. We have a bunch of heart mail.
Oh, you do.
We're going to have to do one like Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have that wonderful mystery box from Susan Simmons, which I'm like, oh, I so want to open. And I just want to say thank you to you guys.
I know.
Especially Susan. And thank you, because they got written. They sent me brushes. And I'm like, and actually, at this point, it's like just nice to get them because they're sold out everywhere. Did you know that, John?
I did not.
Yeah.
Oh, all the brushes are paint sold out?
Yeah. People are saying it's Sherpa related. No, they are. I'm not making that up. They really are.
That's awesome.
So I went and got some blue and some brown. I'm going to get some white here. And I'm going to just kind of come here underneath.
You're off the camera.
I'm off the camera.
I think that's great. If we made a run on Simply Simmons brushes, that would be great.
I'm going to just bring this right here. I'm just trying to be kind of crazy. Guys, don't feel bad if this is one of those weird paintings. You're like, this is really weird. I don't know what's happening. Because that's what we're doing. We're stepping on, we're going rogue. We're mavericks. Which apparently means it's a really big wave. I don't know how that actually applies. But okay. So you see his face is starting to sort of flesh in, right?
Yep.
I'm just getting different colors to talk about what I feel like could be happening on his face. I'm going to get some yellow ochre, and I'm going to come...
I like that color.
You do like yellow ochre. John's become this huge fan of yellow ochre lately. He's just painting it on everything. He keeps getting my golden ochre and just using it. Hey, golden, your paint's being used for all kinds of car projects.
It works.
I'm coming back this way with this wonderful color and just helping define this little space here. We're going to come back and make a little shadow in there later, but Right now, this stage, you've got to cover the canvas. You got to start sealing it in with colors. This abstract pug is about being crazy. Remember, it's not the result of your painting, guys. It is the experience, the fun you have, the laughter you have. Some paintings, it's going to click for you and you're going to get it right away, right? And some of them, maybe you're just like, I had a good time, but it didn't all really resolve. That's what gesso's for.
Mm-hmm.
And you still got all the benefits of the painting. So no pressure. Yeah. But you can do this. This is about, I have this put under the two hoot level. You guys will have to let me know if I got it correct.
Well, Kirsten was wondering if this is live.
If this is live? Yeah. Hi, Kirsten. I feel like that answers that. Don't you, John?
I think so.
Or we're really psychic.
Well, you know, you have that whole grandma thing.
Yeah, no, it's hard to tell on YouTube. They don't have like a thing that really identifies it for sure is live. And I think that's, you know, something that the system will definitely have to think about. You know, what's nice about YouTube for a completely free service, they just provide you and me this free place to store these painting levels. I mean, it's like crazy. Think about how much you pay for storage. It's free. I get to use this service for free.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have to put ads on my videos. I can just be up here just doing whatever I feel like, making 20-hour videos, and they'll let me. And they have all these extra services, all these free training things when they think you might need it. You might need some help to grow. Like, they're like, you're doing pretty good. Would you like some help? Anyways, they're just getting the live thing going. But you have, they're so smart.
Oh, yeah.
This is not me kissing up to YouTube. If you had been to Creator Day, you would be freaking out, too. You'd be like, it was like crazy how good looking and smart these kids were. It was like Aaron Spelling cast YouTube.
I think he did.
He did. I'm telling you, there's like, everybody looked like a model. I'm not even exaggerating. And then their resumes were like, used to work at the NSA, cured diseases, is an Olympian. I'm not kidding. And now is the head of the user interface.
They're just like.
And the kid was like 24. And I'm like, what am I doing with my life? What is going on? Did that freak you out, John? Because it freaked me out.
I think it's awesome.
It was crazy. I got to put out some more blue. This is a very paint-intensive painting. I'm going to put out some more blue.
So Valerie has a message for all of the other Sherpettes out there.
Oh, okay, Valerie, give it.
She just checked, and Jerry's has the SS Extra Firm Long Handle Number 10 Bright in stock for $329.
In stock, right now.
So go clean them out.
Clean them out, man. Because actually, seriously... It's under $5. What is it? Like $3?
Yes, I think she said three something. Let me scroll back up to it. $3.29.
$3.29. Yeah. Get them all. This thing is bananas. I have a $60 brush in here that's the same size by a reputable company that I am choosing not to paint with. To paint with this. I'm not sponsored, even though they sent me a box of brushes.
Which we are going to happily open and
which we're
going
to happily open and enjoy. But that is not a sponsorship. They just did it because they're like, so glad you like our brushes. Here, have some. And I was like, finally, art is respected like the makeup mavens. It's not like anyone's going to send me any free makeup for how I do my face. I really need, you know, that don't... He's a little off color, so, but I really need Willem to do my makeup.
Yeah.
I really do. I need Willem to do my makeup.
Funny.
Yeah, but you should realize he's blue. What is that the word for it?
I don't know.
It's blue. Yeah. He tells definitely grown-up jokes.
Yeah.
It would not be a Watch with Kids show.
No.
And also, if you're at all offended by anything.
Yeah.
You can probably only watch him if nothing offends you. Would be my... I don't know. That's my takeaway. Was that your takeaway, John?
Yep, pretty
much. But he could really do my makeup, and I feel like I would look better.
Yeah, probably. So.
But I'd have, tape right here. I'd be like this. We're going to do art today.
So, Mr. Puggles?
Mr. Puggles?
Or the, where did it go? Hold on. We've got Sir Pugs-a-Lot.
Sir Pugs-a-Lot.
Which I thought was very,
I'm getting a yellow ochre and a little titanium white. I'm just going to paint in his muzzle. What do you have also?
I'm going back over to find. There were a couple other really cute names that just scrolled by. I'm going to wait for him to come back up again.
I'm going to color in everything but his nose.
We've got like 140 people out here painting along with you today. They're really loving the pug.
That's fantastic. I hope you guys are having fun. Take this not too seriously. The great thing about it being abstract is nobody can call you on your painting at all. Because you'd be like, it's abstract. Stop. You don't get it. It's abstract. It's totally off. Do you remember art school, John? Somebody brings some ridiculous project to the front and be like, it's conceptual abstract modernisting art. And I'm like, oh, well, then it just means it's nonsense. There's some Jeff Goldsworthy is brilliant artist, does conceptual modernist abstract art in a naturalist medium, mm-hmm. which basically mean man works in ice. It's up for a day and then it's gone. See, this is art because even though it's abstract, even though it's crazy, if you walked up on a frozen beach and saw it, you'd be like,
yeah. Yeah.
Who's, you know, it's art. Makes art with mud, but you know, it's art.
What's the other guy who does all the nature stuff? Where he makes
That's
the,
what I'm talking
okay,
about.
Yeah. He's the piles of the rocks and stuff.
Yeah. He's a Scottish artist.
Yeah.
So good. It like makes me want to go to Scotland. He did this thing with mud where he painted this wall with mud. And you're like, look, it's a mud wall. That's interesting, dude. And then as it dried, patterns were revealed. And like for 2 days, there's this gorgeous pattern. And then it finished drying. It all fell off the wall.
Wow.
Just like, see, that's art. If you put it outside and your trash man's like, I think that belongs to somebody. It's probably art. Just saying. That's probably right. Okay, don't Buckley. Flame me.
Oh, you're fine. Abstract. Everybody has an opinion on different art. I'm just trying to find where it went. Pug abstract. Pugstract.
Pugstract. Okay, look at this. Pugstract. So I have sort of blended this out here, and I feathered this here. So I've got this nice little shape happening on his face, and it creates this little thing here. I've gotten a little crazy. It's kind of become a mustache. I'll probably have to get that in hand. Maybe. I'm going to come back with some blue. I think I got a little happy. I don't know. Does that ever happen to any of you? You're painting and you just got a little happy?
Yeah.
So when you get a little happy like I just did there, especially on an abstract like this, I can go back and redefine that shape.
Yeah.
I just was like, wee-hoo, painting it out.
April's like, I just claim all my paintings are abstracts.
Oh, it's a genius move. I agree.
Viv was saying, we're gonna have to ask you to do some European brush reviews,
yeah,
because they're having a real hard time getting that Simply Simmons over there. And when they do, it's like 20, you know, around 12 pounds a brush. It's like,
yeah. So interestingly enough, Dollar and Rally's in Europe, and I can ask the rep to send me some. I'll ask the rep if she'll send me some brushes that are economy for
the
Europe.
European spec.
Yeah, European spec. Because I know Robert Simmons is sold there, but Simply Simmons is not. So maybe I can ask her, and when we go to the material show, because I don't even know where to start.
Yeah, we'll ask.
Like Mona sent put up the picture of brushes. I'm like, I don't know any of those brushes. What?
Well, we'll ask for some help there.
Yeah, so we'll get some help, and we'll work it out. We'll work as a team. We'll work as a community, and we will figure out what brushes are good where.
Yes.
That's like our new goal. So I'm going to take a little of, I think, maybe I'm going to do some red and brown here,
mm-hmm.
and a little white, and I'm going to paint just this part of the tongue. So what I've done is I'm kind of outlining it, and I'm going to paint this part here with this color. Here we go. Painting it. Just kind of, it doesn't have to be perfect. Look, I'm not even worried that these little things are blending because I'm going to come in and define and refine. This is all about define and refine. And I'm out of purple. Oh. Ever go to mix and you're like, there is no paint.
You just used that purple right on up.
I just used it up. Woo, it was a coffee day and the coffee isn't even helping me.
You need some more coffee?
I don't know. Is there enough coffee?
More sippy coffee.
I've added a little Dioxazine Purple to my Cad Red. I'm so excited about Saturday. I'm looking at all your guys' suggestions. The good news is a lot of suggestions for Alice in Wonderland. And mm-hmm. the only reason we're not doing an abstract Alice in Wonderland tomorrow is that there's an Alice in Wonderland collab I'm in. And that's dropping on the 5th.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm going to show you on the 5th, only those who are watching today and watch this video will even know it was there, how get your watercolor paper, because I'm going to show you how acrylics can be a little bit like watercolors.
Yes.
And we're going to learn how to do one of the most popular pins on Pinterest.
That'll be awesome.
It is. You're going to like frame it and put it up on your wall and be like, oh my gosh. So I've done the purple and red down there, and then I'm going to get a bunch of white, 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 and then I'm going to come do the top of this half of the tongue.
And I'm going to, real quick, just say thank you to Bonnie. She always is out there making sure that our community knows where things are at, what's going on. And, you know, I really appreciate making sure that, you know, the questions are there. And she always asks everyone to comment, like, and subscribe, and yeah. I really appreciate that.
We do. So. We do, and we really appreciate how nice you guys keep our community.
Yeah.
Every time I'm doing this YouTube counseling mentoring thing, and so you talk to the gamers, and I got to say, the more I'm watching the gaming segment, the more I'm just grateful for the community we have in art being so nice, because these gamers are putting up these gorgeous, awesome, funny videos. They're, like, so funny, and reviews and all the stuff, and it's all this hard work. And then when they go live, it's like, yeah, there's some beautiful fans, but in there it's just like a lot of screaming at them.
And I have to say thank you to all of you guys for making this as fun as you do.
Yeah.
And Cinnamon, thank you for letting me be part of this. I love you.
Oh my God, I love you too. I love you, John. I love my husband. I have to take a minute. Reset. You get me.
Sorry.
You just come along and you get me. You know that? All right. What was Sherpa doing? Does anyone remember?
We were painting in some abstract stuff.
I don't even remember what I was doing. I changed brushes.
Yeah.
So I'm now painting the number 4 bright firm filament that I got from the Texas Art Supply tour video.
Which you should go check out. It's more nausea cam than you can handle.
Oh, dude. That thing was like nausea cam on another level. And I rallied for you. I said, I don't know, John. Are they going to be able to deal? And he's like, they're fine. So I'm going to paint in his eye with this dark color I made with the brown and the blue. Because we love what our Bert Sienna does with our phthalo blue. And since we've all done color charts, right? We're totally familiar with how we're doing it.
Mm-hmm.
This is blue dominant. I love that I can say that now. And everyone's going to be like, oh, yeah, I totally know what that means. Totally know what that means. Just putting this in. There you go. I've got this little white here and this little white here.
Yeah.
Come work that out in a second. In a second, though. First, I'm going to get this in. And then I feel like I really want coffee.
You really want coffee?
I feel like I really want coffee. You guys doing okay?
I think they're doing okay. I think I can find you coffee, though.
Can you find me some coffee?
But I can't push buttons while I put that.
I'll just finish this and wait for coffee to show up. I got a cup here. I'm really loving the Blueberry Mountain with the soy creamer. We're such a high-end production show that we just break for coffee. We need a coffee break video. Yeah, this one. We need a coffee break video where it like pours coffee. There's no story of me without coffee. There's no story of Ginger from Ginger Cook Live without coffee. No story. Oh, and for the people that are here, Ian did pick a winner and he's making a video really soon. I loved all of the suggestions you guys made for YouTubers that we could follow. That was fantastic. You really suggested some great ones and the whole thing was pretty cool. Pretty cool of you. I'm stalling so I can have a cup of coffee. Go ahead. So like, if you're here live, we can hang out and chat. You guys can chat with each other. If you're here on the replay, I'll probably edit this out later. You can fast forward until that's done.
That's right. Well, it's right. Coffee's making for you.
Coffee's making?
Yeah.
All right. So I'm here. I'm rinsing out my brush a little bit. I've got these little sort of white corners. This is not the most important thing in the world, but I just want that there. And I'm going to weirdly get some black. And I'm going to come and just fill this in. I want this to just be just a slightly different tone or value than everything else. And we're going to be coming back with other colors in here anyways, so I just wanted to define that this cat eye was here and doing this thing that this eye is doing, that eyes do. Hopefully we're enjoying abstract week.
I think
this is an experiment to see what does YouTube think of Abstract Week.
Everyone seems to be enjoying it.
We're liking Abstract Week. Mm-hmm. There might be more Abstract Weeks. Abstract is super fun. There's some fun stuff like pouring mediums. I made a turquoise. I used phthalo blue, cad yellow, and white. And depending on what colors I make dominant is what range of aqua or turquoise I get. But again, here, it's just important. You're like, but you painted out his nostrils that I worked really hard to draw. Then don't paint out the nostrils. Paint them in a different color. I'm just going to put them back in a minute. I do this a lot. Like, I'll sketch something in and be like, I'll put you back in a minute.
Wrong button.
What?
I was looking at the palette.
Well, it's always nice to look at the palette. Artist palettes are really pretty. Artist palettes are really pretty.
Now, do you put agave in this coffee?
No. Okay. I just do the soy creamer, so sweet because it's vanilla soy.
Okay.
If we put agave in, nobody would be able to drink it. So he's blocked in. Check him out. He's not bad right now. You can almost, in abstract terms, be like, done. Hanging on the wall. You could, actually. Here's why you actually couldn't, though. You want to know why he's not ready to be done. He doesn't have enough value shift. So if you take the object that he is out of the equation, that he's an adorable pug that we're painting, and you just look at the shapes and forms, he's not really that exciting yet, and he's a little centrally placed. I do that sometimes. I centrally place stuff for you guys instead of taking it on and off the canvas, because that makes it a little easier for you in the beginning of your journey. Right? As we move along into our three hoop painting, sometimes stuff is going to be really... He's okay. Are you okay? Your feet okay? Okay. Because you're barefoot. Okay.
It's just a ceramic mug.
Hey, networks, you should totally pick us up. We drop things.
And so, yes. If you were asking if we are alive, we are alive.
We're so alive. It's a hot mess. But that's why he's centered in here instead of like being like diagonally here or some crazy position stuff. I kind of got interesting with the tongue here to make him a little more interesting. And he doesn't have enough value. And there's not enough going on to make him on his own an interesting composition, interestingly enough. So while I've got this nice turquoise, I'm going to add a little more of it to my brush. And I'm going to come down here. And I'm going to very nicely run this along his inner lip. And then very expressively scrumble this up and down. Can we? Yeah, we can see that. So this is a light turquoise. Right? Then I'm going to get some phthalo blue and white. Just kind of come under his jaw with that. Maybe add a little spot here. Come under the tongue. Add a little spot there. See? So we've got these values that I'm enforcing. Come along this part here. And then it's okay if you want to take a little bit of that right there. And then a little bit on the outside there. Expressive.
Expressive.
Expressive. You could go like that too.
Oh yeah, that does look cool.
Look cool.
Put your close up camera back on that.
It's just super fun. You're like, what did you do?
You just made a little scribble there, and
so
it was awesome.
What happens to me is I've had a lot of years designing and stuff, and so in art school they make you for like a whole year of design, you arrange white and black paper till it doesn't suck. And so I just did a little middle wrinkle here, and then I came on the outside of my purple, and then I went scramble, very expressively.
Now, if you were happy with the color of the eyes,
change it.
Oh, you could change it.
This is abstract. You make them red. You make them anything. You could make them piebald. Really, if you have done your color charts from Big Art Quest, and if you got your tracing down. You could do this guy in different color schemes all day. Because remember when we did the heart abstract and I was like, use all the paint?
Yep.
That's what this was getting ready for. I'm like Mr. Miyagi. I'm like, wax on, wax off. You're not in class. You're abstract art. Wax on, wax off. Now go save the world with your kick. Okay. More creamer. No, there's nothing interesting in my coffee today.
I did not kill the mug on the way over there.
And he did not kill the mug. This was my, I get by with a little help from my friends. Mug was given to me by my friend Tasha. And it's an important mug and it did not die.
No.
An important mug died.
Yeah.
And that's okay. Mm. So I've got this kind of thought about here and I'm like, okay, let's get my little number four bright. I can do this entire painting with this bright or the my number 10. I could have done it actually all with the other one too. And so I want to come under here.
I'm just, you're like halfway between the cameras. The one I couldn't see your hand and you're not looking.
I've gotten some Dioxazine purple and white.
You get the close up on you?
Yeah, I'm going to adjust that close up.
Where do you have? There, probably there.
Is that good? Do I need to zoom in or are we good?
That's probably pretty good there.
Okay. You guys let us know because this is your camera. I'm going to come along with this mixture of just Dioxazine purple and white. Fairly chromatic piece. And I'm going to just, look at that.
Oh, yeah.
So this is, if you're good at calligraphy, this will snap to you. If you're good at just letting go and being expressive and, you know, your garden is just a wild growing thing and you've got flowing hair, you know what I mean? If this is like, if that's your space, this whole painting is going to snap. If you're an orderly person and this painting is a struggle, enjoy the struggle and release the result. We've got some orderly abstracts coming up on the schedule, like with tape and plans that you will love.
Yeah.
Right? There is a painting expression that fits your personality style. It's fun to try on. You know, it's like when you try on different clothes. I'm going to grab a little red and maybe, ooh, I'm going to get with a little yellow right here. Little red and yellow, and then maybe a little white there. Come here along this top line and just pull this down. Look at this. I'm pulling it down, 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 pulling it down. So I'm using implied line, texture, and color to define that. All right. Grab some just white. And come along just this part of the tongue. Look at that. It's as if he has a little tongue. And then I can even come to the tip here. And add that. Because I'm just crazy like that.
Oh, yeah.
You know? You can come over here with this little bit of color and just pop it right there. Look at that. Tie, tie. So I'm finding my balance. That's what I'm actually doing. You think I'm doing this other stuff, but I'm actually finding my balance. I'm going to get some just purple. I'm going to come inside this space in his mouth and define this just a little bit more. And I'm going to kind of make this line not as, you know, clean. Come along here, and I'm thinking about how can I... This, if you're trying to think of where this is artistically in the movement of art, this is almost brutalist in that I'm using rough, intense, conflicting brush strokes
Melody
to create
says,
energy.
Melody says that you make it look so easy.
I do. And I know that is sometimes unfair when someone toot, toot.
But it really is easy once you start doing it.
It is easy. It's like one of those things. It's like easy to ride a bike, but when you first get on the thing, it doesn't feel easy, does it? You're like, what is this craziness? Mm. Right? And then there's that one Yahoo that just gets on the bike and rides off and makes you feel like, what?
Yep.
Because there's always got to be one that makes it look like it's not hard. Yeah?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, Jason. Oh. You're fine. No,
oh, I saw your hands go up, so I was like, stretching. Is this the signal?
No, I was just stretching. No, we've got a bunch of people. Jason was actually asking when the aprons and shirts would be available. He was hoping for some large guy shirts, too. And I was like...
Oh, that's one thing we're looking at is making sure we have friendlier sizes.
Yeah, and they'll be available on our website as soon as we have all that ready to go.
I've got some yellow, white, and a little touch of green, and I'm coming here. And I'm taking advantage of the fact that this heavy body paint, you know, leaves some texture. You'll notice I'm not really mixing the paint, right, on my canvas. And I'm not even worried if it's dirty and it picks up a little bit of other paint. That's actually to my benefit in this particular case.
Mm.
I'm coming along here. So it's about the lines that I hold and the lines that I just disrespect. All right, isn't that fun?
Mm-hmm.
That little scrumbly. And I can come back with some even more white, just white, and maybe come right here. And I'm just pulling this white right here. So much fun to do. Just right in this little center spot, I'm trying to create this sort of abstracted highlight. This is going to make you crazy. Don't stress out.
Mm-hmm.
I really don't. I'm going to get some red and some yellow and make that dark orange like we were talking about. This is going to be red dominant.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to come underneath here and define the inside of that muzzle. Look at that go.
That's awesome.
Let's pull it up. Breaking up those brush strokes. If you've been struggling randomizing your clouds and randomizing your trees, this mm-hmm. is another really good opportunity to practice those skills. I love how like I'm going to stress y'all out. I call it an opportunity. This is an opportunity for you to practice.
Bang, 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 bang.
It's your opportunity. Don't you feel special?
Homework.
This is your opportunity. So this, you know, I'm not like this had a little less white in it and went a little brighter.
That's
but
okay.
That's okay for this because of what we're doing here. What we're doing here makes that just fine. Come along this little lip here. Look at that, just breaking that up. Isn't that awesome?
That is.
Dude, I love that. Just do that. I just wanna put some of this somewhere else, but I'm gonna resist it. What happens, the honest truth of when I'm abstracting, I'm gonna show you something I would do. Normally in my abstract, I would find another space that I feel like this could be. And I would just put it there like a crazy person.
Just add some.
Yeah. My brain's working. My right brain's working all the time, and it's talking to me. And don't worry, it says only good things. But it's usually stuff like your upper left is looking a little flat. Add some zing. Doesn't say anything scary. Just saying. It's a pretty friendly thing here. I'm going to get some purple and blue, and add a little white, but purple and blue. I'm going to come along my nose here and down here. Maybe even a little bit right there. And then I'm going to make a little line right up the center.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Pull this back to the tip of my brush. And if you'll remember the shapes that we had, so we had the little right there. And I just want to put it right here. I just can't help myself. Sorry. You just want to do it.
Yep.
Because it's fun. So I've got this purple and this blue. I'm going to get a lot more white. And with the more white.
So Jody was just asking if there's going to be any Sherpa stickers.
Yeah.
I was like, yes. She wants some to decorate her wheelchair. So I was like, that'll load
yeah.
her make some.
Definitely. So. Definitely Sherpa stickers. I'm going to need more white than even that.
And you should tell us what you want as Sherpa stickers. Just put them in the comments.
Yeah.
Or you put them on the Facebook page. Anything that you think you'd like that kind of stuff, please tell us. Because right now we're trying to work out just exactly what we're going to make for you. So if you want it, we'll try to do it.
So I'm just trying to define that little space out. So see, I've got that sort of scrambled in. I'm going to come back with some more thoughts on that later.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to get some deep purple. I haven't even rinsed my brush here. And I might come... He needs some wrinkles. We need to know there's some wrinkles here, so I'm going to give him some wrinkle space.
You have to adjust your close-up on that.
Okay, moving that up. Look at him. He's like popping in. He's getting better and better. He's going to be better than my test one. He could be better than my test one. He's going to be so good.
Mmm. With your sippy.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So there's been a positive response to the idea of some pear stickers.
You guys deserve them, man. How you guys doing? Doing okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Breathe. It's okay. You're doing fine. Like, it's abstract, so it's got to be kind of okay.
Yeah.
You know, that's just like, sort of like the rule, isn't it?
Yep.
I'm going to get a little red and purple here because I just like that. A little white. And above him, right here above his eyebrow, I want to make this kind of little curvy shape. with this. I'm not even painting all the canvas out underneath. It's showing through.
No. Let's see here. Linda was asking about what book you keep referencing your right brain, left brain.
Yeah. Drawing on the right side of the brain pretty much explains it.
Yeah.
And I think breaks down why talent is a myth just the best. I mean, yeah, of course there's potential. People have an acuity. Like some people may be built a little bit better than others to swim and they might go to the Olympics, but other people can swim a lap very successfully and quickly.
Oh, yeah.
You know, art isn't about being the best painter on the planet. It's being able to paint well and enjoy the experience, right? And so, but in right now, the thinking in art is like, you know, there's some sort of like competitive heap and it's sort of like Highlander and we're taking off each other's head because there can be only one. But then nobody can decide what the one is and they're all on the top of their heaps going, no, it's this. This is art. And you're just like, ah, I don't even want to deal with it. Art is just the experience you're having creatively. And the goal is to just give you lots of tools and expressions so you can do that well. So one of the things I want to show you, and hopefully it can zoom in enough to do it, and the camera won't see all the streakiness here in the paint over the canvas. That's the expression. Just saying. And you can see he's starting to take shape.
Yeah.
He's starting to take form, and that's pretty exciting. I got to put out more yellow. I think I need to go buy some yellow paint. Getting down to the dregs of my tubes. Dregs!
We got to get some more. We got to go see what sales are happening.
Yep. Got to work your sales. Work your sales. So it makes a nice turquoise there. I'm going to get a nice amount of white. I'm going to come here. I'm going to take this light color and define some light wrinkles that are happening here. Might add that a little bit in the nose. Nah, I didn't like that.
There's some good sticker suggestions happening out
what
here.
What are the sticker suggestions?
So, let's see here. Let's go back in here. I want to make sure I attribute them to the right
people. I'm
going
to take this over here and add this here and come over here and go off.
Just a little scribble there.
Yeah. So hopefully, pause me and rewind me if you're like, what the heck did you do? Don't be like writing me all angry going, I don't know what you did. This is abstract. We got to just be a little bit looser, a little bit more like, it's all right. It's all good. It's groovy. I'm fine.
So what would you think
over here?
Like some sticker sheets of all of the paintings that have been done.
I would love sticker sheets of all the paintings that have been done.
Where are you going? Okay. I think that's a really good one. Kim Sim was suggesting.
I kind of lost my thing there, but that's okay because it's abstract. I go off. It's fine. The nose does not have enough value differences and needs to be resolved later.
Okay.
Just something I'm seeing. Just so you know.
I see.
Doesn't have enough. Got to fix it later. So I definitely want to talk about some wrinkles and some pugness happening. So I'm drawing those legs sort of up there. I'd like to come into the ears, maybe on this side with this light blue. Just color in this field here. Maybe here too with this almost the sky blue right here. See, I'm just making you see. It's crazy. Like how good, like up here, he's a hot mess. Other things to know about your abstract. They look terrible right here. All abstracts in this space make you feel like you should just give up and run away from home.
Yeah.
Abstracts from across the room look brilliant. So remember to back up and look at your artwork or look at it in a mirror or take a picture of it on your cell phone so you can disassociate from the up close that you're seeing. It will help you have a better bead on what's going on.
Yeah.
Because, you know, you want one. I'm going to come over and mix some yellow ochre and some cad.
Your eyebrows are on fleek.
Whose eyebrows? His eyebrows?
Yeah.
They're on fleek. It's like, I know mine aren't in because I didn't even do them. And I'm really, my natural hair color is red, but it's strawberry blonde, so Just means I have no eyebrows. And the sun is not my friend.
So, I mean, so many sticker ideas. And Rhea, who's asking about the app, it's coming along nicely.
Yes, it is coming along nicely. Not quickly.
Not quickly, but it's coming along nicely.
Those guesstimations they give you about it'll take this long, those are just made up. They're just making that up.
Then they go, oh, yeah, and I have 2 weeks of vacation.
It just sums it up, doesn't it?
Yep.
So I'm going to come here with this color because I really like it. And I'm going to come off here. And I'm going to come here. I'm just scrumbling and I'm being very lyrical with the brush. Now, I'm going to have to break this space in a minute, but I just like what I'm doing there. Are we liking where we're going?
Yep.
Let's pick up some more just cad red. That's really fun for me.
It was as if it were...
I'm going to come on this outer ear and just strengthen that right there because I'm just feeling it. And then there. I feel like I want to define that shape. Pop that ear. Let's pop that ear. Let's get CAD. That's what CAD is for, by the way, if you're wondering. To pop your space. So I'm very loosely sketch around it. Maybe I just do that right there. What do we think of that? I like that. And I want you guys to be thinking about, like, what do I think of that? How do I feel about that? Some places I can just put my CAD right here on his muzzle. I could just put some CAD... right here. Isn't that exciting?
Yeah.
Drama. Because I'm adding drama. Drama, drama, drama. I'm doing his eyes last. Got some yellow ochre and white.
So I was laughing over here. They've got such good ideas for some stickers out here.
Really?
Yeah. So
I'm pulling this up over his eyebrow. And then I'm going to get this yellow ochre and white, which is almost like a parchment color. I really like it. And I'm going to pull this just under this eye space here. And I'm going to do something similar over here. And I'm going to define the top of this. Rinse this out really, 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 really well. I think I'm going to make some green, John.
Oh, yeah?
Well, so you were telling me something about stickers.
Oh, no, it's okay. I'm letting you roll on there. No, there's a lot of great ideas for stickers. Save the drama for your art sticker.
Oh, I wish I could just, like, give that to family members and be like, that's how I feel.
Yeah, and it was Flame and Mona almost at the same time said glitter beard sticker. And they really like the idea of all of the artwork that Chuck has done, the variations of you.
Yeah, that is actually, we've talked to Chuck, and he's thinking very strongly, and I think it's an absolute yes, of doing a sister coloring book that's Sherpa Life of all of his doodles.
Yeah, and it's actually in the works.
Yeah, and it's looking pretty good. You guys are seeing some signs of it over on the Angeloni page.
Yeah.
So we'll So how's that looking there? You guys feeling his puggleness?
They're loving it.
Now, this is deviating from the... I'm going to have to change my thumbnail because this has gone crazy.
You've gone off the reservation.
You've got to go off the reservation. One of the things that you want to do in abstract art is give yourself permission to follow the flow of what the paint is telling you you need to do. Mm-hmm. Sometimes that will work out. Sometimes it's going to be a gesso project. But that part isn't really important. What's important is that you find the painting in the pug. You find the art in this everyday. Look at this. How fun is this, right?
Mm-hmm.
You did this big on your wall. Your friends would be like, oh my gosh, I love that so much.
Being all pop arty, it's DJ Pugs a lot.
DJ Pugs a lot. Now I feel like more needs to happen down here. So I'm going to come down with this here. I made a little purple and red. I just felt like this was just looking very plain and didn't have any energy. And you can kind of see even here I'm being very whimsical with this. And I'm not respecting the previous brush strokes. I'm breaking lines because
mm-hmm.
that's what you do. Break lines.
There's a big request for your bob hair. sticker. They love
that one. Could be dangerous, guys, because Bob Ink does not play. So I made our phthalo blue, burnt umber, and white mix here. I'm gonna come here a little bit with that and make sure that there's some thought happening here. Just adding that, curving this. I'm curving these strokes.
I have to get a close-up camera there.
Do I? See how this is starting to? We'll get right up on it. So if, hopefully you can see those strokes. Can you see these?
There's, oh yeah. There's a lot of dog lovers out here today.
This is, we have another very important dog coming up for Halloween.
We got a couple dogs we want to do. Not Halloween.
Yeah. No, not Halloween. Valentine's
Day. I was like, that's a long time away. Not Halloween.
Get ready for Halloween.
Boy,
because I know y'all will be here. No. Valentine's Day, we're going to do a very special and dear to me Pomeranian with roses.
Yes. We'll do a Pomeranian with roses next.
Pomeranian with roses. Which, not next, but we've got one coming up. You'll see the design it's going to be like.
It's going to be awesome.
I'm kidnapping you on a fandom moment of mine, really. But it's a Pomeranian with roses, so I think you guys will love him. Be like all wonderful and fluffy. Yeah. And
he's an cute. Awesome pom.
A little more like those papillons that I did. Yeah. All right, so he's looking pretty good here. The only thing I'm thinking is I'd like some drama up here.
Some more drama?
Do we feel like we need more drama? I feel like I do.
Get the nausea cam up there.
Trust yourself when you feel like you need more drama. Now, does it need to be darker drama or lighter drama? I'm inclined to go lighter in this particular drama. So I'm inclined to pull a bunch of yellow and white and come up here and, oh, yeah, and see, trust your instincts.
Just threw some.
Just trust them.
Add some more in there. That's great.
But it just needed some energy and some thought and expression. See, some energy and some thought and some expression. This is why abstract art is so challenging to teach, because really what it's about is the painter finding themselves and their feeling in the painting.
Mm-hmm.
Which is, it's learning to trust that inner voice and then being okay with it if your inner voice leads you astray, which it will sometimes do.
You want more?
No, it's just this line bugs me.
Oh.
I'm going to break that line up. Now I feel better. It was like right across there, and I was like, I don't like you. You make me so mad. I don't like you. You make me so mad. What?
You're just... I love how you talk to your canvas sometimes. You're just
like, you guys should know, that's not like show work either. That like just happens. John has to listen to that. Here he'll be like, who are you talking... My kid's actually like, who are you talking to, Mom?
I have to come in and check on her.
Are you okay? My daughter's like, it's so weird. You've got to stop. It's embarrassing, Mom. It's really embarrassing. Stop talking to yourself.
So... DJ Pugs a lot says dance, dance, dance.
Dance, dance, dance. Is he looking lovely?
He's looking awesome.
So his nose needs some resolution here. I'm not happy with the resolution of his nose. And his eyes need to be resolved. And then we're good.
Yeah, we're good.
We painted an abstract pug. So let's work out this nose. I've got a number 2 bright Simply Simmons firm filament. These I bought with my own money. And you know what? It wasn't a big deal. I bought a whole group of brushes for like $20.
So they're and very...
Yeah, I didn't have to wait for a twice a year sale where $60 brushes were $1, and then I, you know, buy the wrong brushes because I get overexcited. Anybody ever do that? It's like such a good sale. You're like, I take them all, and you get them home, and you're like, ugh.
You didn't flick all the
I didn't flick all the brushes.
You didn't flick all the brushes. I love the brush flicking videos that I'm seeing. They're so awesome.
And the portraits, you guys. Now, remember to add your quotes to your portraits on your quest.
Yes.
Be sure to add your quotes, but the portraits you guys are doing are fantastic. They're fantastic. You have no, like, I hope you just appreciate how amazing y'all are doing.
Get a close-up camera there.
Okay, I'm going to get my close-up camera there.
Whack my mic.
You did?
I hit it with my hand.
So I need a darker value here is what I've got going on, and I need to, there we go. There. Now he has a nose. Shh.
Feel better there?
Get in there. Bet the dog lovers feel better, too.
Yeah. So when are we going to do our next heart mail?
We've got a bunch of it. We can do it Sunday. We're trying to... I don't know. Sunday is like... Saturday after the free-form abstract?
Hmm. We could totally do that.
We might owe them a video, depending on how they felt about it.
We should probably... We'll get up on the schedule here, though.
Now, I've added a little yellow and white to create this reflection right here. I'm going to add it right there and right there. See, now he has a nose. Doesn't he have a nose? Look at that.
Yep.
Abstracted nose. Now, up close... Oh, here's a very important thing. So, up close... Horrible mess. Look at that hot mess up close.
And you can see all. It's good. Bring it back up here. Just one more. I like you can see how the big thick paint is around the eyes and on the muzzle, and how on fleek your eyebrows are. If you go down just a little bit, you can see how they're, as she says.
See, it's just a hot mess. Okay, but when you get it back here, put it on the other camera. Look how beautiful it is from a distance. It's crazy. Best, most fun in the world, right?
Yeah.
Best, most fun in the world. Love it, love it, love it, love it, love it. So I'm going to take my burnt sienna and my phthalo blue, burnt sienna dominant, and make quite a dark color.
Yeah.
Quite a dark color. And I'm going to come under my lid here and shade halfway down my eyeball with this color. Shade halfway down my eyeball with this color. I'm going to do that both sides. So this is like a makeup tutorial with painting. Come and line underneath the lid here. Halfway down. So just so you know, everybody at YouTube thinks it's crazy we're using the live system this way. I'm wondering what you guys think of this thing. Like, because they did not know that DIY would go live. They never imagined it. They made it like entirely for gaming. And maybe the music people.
Yeah.
So it's been their reaction to what we're doing is very interesting. So I've got this shaded the halfway down. Then just grab just your burnt paint in the lower half of the eyeball here.
Now, I'm pretty sure the answer, I know the answer to this, but... I just had a question asked if you could use texture paint or paste with this.
Yes.
And that you could just add as much.
Yeah. You can make this a very impasto piece. So this or is maybe I should do this on this other side. I need to go the other eye.
Yeah,
I want you guys to see me put this thing in.
I was gonna say, you adjusted the close-up camera and then painted the other eye.
Yeah. That was abstract. It's a performance piece. Roll with it. I meant that. So I intentionally considered it. Having observed artists that went before me, and
what are you?
So just that lower eyeball there.
Yeah, we saw just a little bit of painting there.
Just a little bit of painting there, and then you be out of yellow ochre so that you have to look for it. That's the next important step of what you're doing. Be totally out of yellow ochre, and have no idea where you put it down. There it is. Do exactly that. Jeez.
So Donna says that Little Brush Emma.
Hi, Emma.
That you met at VidCon is here. And
hi, Donna. I met Donna at VidCon, too. Yeah. Hi, Donna and Emma. Loved your brush stories, The Secret Lives of Brushes.
Mm-hmm.
Emma, actually, pretty darn cool kid.
Yeah.
Which, of course, Donna, also a pretty darn cool kid, has a secret hedgehog name, which I find super awesome. Do you remember the secret hedgehog name? Mm. All right, so I'm going to do this highlight in the sidebar. Are we on the right up close one? So I'm going to just go in like this. Right, like this. And I'm letting this come in here. I'm going to do the same thing, other eye. But this is not the tight eye. We're paying attention to the things.
Your camera wondered.
Where did it go? Dude, where did it go? Why did it do that? It was like, I don't like your eye. I'm going away. A wild horse, if you don't tether it down, it does its own thing. So I'm just sort of doing that reflection. This is similar to things that we've done in other eyes that we've done. Right?
Yeah.
I'm going to pull some blue here. I'm going to come here. Just make sure I have this outer space defined. Right? And maybe... Make sure this is defined a little bit too. Just painting that in at each corner. Just painting that in each corner. I want a dark, whatever color you're doing here, just make sure it's a dark color. That would be my recommendation. right? On this very loose. So we've got this sort of reflection of the stuff going through. I'm going to pick up some just black.
Mm-hmm.
Some just black. I'm going to definitely define this underlid area just a little bit, and I'm going to paint like that little ball there. I don't know if you can see it.
Oh, yeah. Just make sure we adjust your close-up camera.
Is this one on the right
one?
Nope, or?
You're on the other eye.
All right, back to the other eye. Camera, hang with me. I need the one that follows me. We need the robot cam.
I want to get a robot camera
like
so
some
bad.
People just want a robot cam. We need a robot cam. Like, it's not even a want for us. It's, like, totally a need. So I'm coming down. I'm just defining that a little bit with the black here. Once I have that in, we'll pull most of the black out of my brush. But I'm not going to wash it because I want a bright reflection, but I don't want a white reflection, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
And I'm going to right here.
Okay, other.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is your performance piece.
I don't know. I don't know where I'm going today. So I'm going to just put a little crazy little reflection there. And then maybe a little dot. And then add a little line of white on the outside. Look at that eye just happen. Look at that eye just totally happen. Where did it come from? It's like a magic trick. Looks like crazy. Looks terrible up front. Looks terrible close up. Look how terrible it looks close up. Go close up. Looks terrible. It just looks like terrible. You get back from it, it's just beautiful. This is like it sings.
Yeah.
It's the most fun. I love that part. Sorry, I got a little excited. I got a little excited there. But I love sharing that with you guys. That it does that. That it has this weird, crazy, like, where you're questioning yourself. Where you question your sanity. You're like, what was I thinking? I don't know why I went to art school. I don't even remember how to paint. You know? You don't even remember it. And then you do something like this. And then you're like, oh. It's so much fun. And then it's there, and you're like, okay, back up, and you can see it. Look at those. Look at those eyes. They're just having a whole little moment, aren't they?
That's a little dog that says, feed me.
He's saying, feed me. He's like, I want some food. I want some food, guys. And you know what I'm going to do? What I love to do. Last thing I'm going to do, I'm going to get in my CAD red. This is why I spend the big bucks right here. And then I'm going to come.
Oh, you're on the wrong eye again.
An outline. That eye with the bright red.
Okay, so you have to go back over. Show me the other eye now.
Okay, sorry.
You're
okay. See?
So we see what we did.
I'm going to do it again over here,
okay.
Though. So
do it
okay.
Over.
Sorry.
All right.
Get so excited. I'm just so excited. I'm going to come in here, and I'm going to add just a little bit of this red. Maybe I'll add it here. See that? Go back to the other side. This is too close. Too close. I'm going to add a couple of these here. I'm going to come here and add that. Maybe I'm going to come here and add that. I'm going to tell that story there, and I'm like, I'm feeling so abstract. And there. Because that color, that pop, that lyrical la-la. I like it too. I like it. I like my little pug. He's so fat and squishy. I've had a day. It's a weird day for me.
It's a good day.
I feel like we did a good painting. Look, I get, I know. I understand. Abstract is hard. You're like, I thought it would be easier if I didn't have to paint it how it looks. And you're like, it's just crazy. But listen, whether it sits in your current set of painting skills and this was just a liberating moment, or whether you were like, not, you're going to be there, but this wasn't that day. Just pay attention to how it just felt to be free. That's what abstract is really about. It's about how to be free in art and how to take risks and how to listen to your heart and your creative side and trust yourself. And anything that encourages you to trust yourself has a value way beyond the product.
Mm-hmm.
So there's this one. Don't worry. For orderly people, we will have like taped geometric abstracts.
Oh, yeah?
Because it went, I mean, like, you know, like Matt, he would just be like, oh, it's a hot mess. I don't like it. He would not like the expressiveness of it because he likes his stuff. There's so many people that want orderly, structural, geometric pieces. Mm-hmm. We're going to do that. And tomorrow, I'm going to go over the list of your suggestions that you can make on the Facebook page. And I'm going to pick some of the popular ones. And we're going to do viewer-directed abstract. That's nice. Why there's no materials list is because we don't know yet.
Well, could you pull up the grab your study that you did for the pug for Mr. Puggles?
Yeah, it went completely off reservation. Just so you know.
Yeah, no, that everyone's interested. It's actually, not. It's kind of the same, just a little different in colors.
Yeah, little off reservation.
But you just change your colors up a bit.
A bit. You sometimes you see a different way through, and you're like, I want to do this. I want to do this other thing. I want to do this. You just go. I wanted more highlights up here. I had a different thing I wanted around the eyes and brows. You know.
Yeah.
He's this Mr. What did we decide his name was?
It's gone. It's, I mean, like, there's been a lot. It's either between DJ Pugs a lot and Sir Pugs. What was it? Sir Puggles?
Sir Puggles.
Sir Puggles was the other one.
Sir Puggles is pretty good.
Yeah.
I'm going to executively Sherpa decide Sir Puggles. Listen, you name your pug. You play with it. You trust it. Look how kind, like, mine are the same, but they're different. So if yours is similar but different, look how okay that is. I don't, you know, it's okay to not make replicas because we're not copy machines and we have these really cool things called copy machines that do it really well. So we don't need to do it.
Yeah.
You know, scribes are very cool, but no longer required.
Nope.
Because Xerox replaced that whole industry. No more scribes. No, you don't have to paint this book 25 times in your lifetime. Just
post
one
up yours.
Book.
We want to see yours.
Which one?
Painting. They're painting on their Facebook page.
Yeah, definitely. Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Post your pugs.
Lots
Tell
of
us
pugs.
What you thought. Tell us what you love. Tell us what you'd love to see. It's your class. It's your time. We love seeing you guys.
We want to see their clever name. That'll be their job, is to show us a picture of their pug with their clever name.
Their clever pug name. And then we got Pomeranian coming up. And we have another very... We're actually getting ready for a really big deal. Dog episode that's going to explode your mind. I have a collaboration coming up with an amazing artist.
I know. It's so cool.
That I'm so excited to share with you. He's just such a gift. And so we're getting ready for something. Yeah, see, Mr. Miyagi, wax on, wax off. You think you're just painting dogs. You're like, I don't want to paint a dog. And then you're going to get there and you're like, oh, now I know why we did it all. So I can go like this.
I have to say thank you to all of our community who's out there, all of our moderators. We love you guys. Thank you so much coming here. Please post up your pictures. I really, really love seeing them. Cinnamon really just, she shows me all the stories and stuff.
Love your portraits.
Yeah. It's so fantastic. We're going to be using it all in there.
See you at the easel really soon.
Love you guys.